Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Most High. God is good, God is faithful, and he's worthy to be praised. This is another glorious day that the Lord has made. And I declare this morning that you will rejoice, you'll be glad in all areas of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. God is faithful, is glorious, is merciful, and that's mercy and faithfulness of God will locate you, your family, your loved ones, even this new week in the mighty name of Jesus. God has done so much for us. And today we are glad, we are rejoicing that again, he has done a miracle in our lives. We have slept, we have woken up, and we have seen a brand new day that he has made. And today we will be filled with blessings. He will load us with his benefits, and will be satisfied in all areas of our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to welcome you to Morning Dew Prayers this day, Sunday, the 8th of October, 2023. And as you join us in prayers, God will locate you. He will see to all your requests. He will answer all your prayers. He will fight for you. He will defend you. He will keep you. He will uphold you. It will establish you in the greatness that he has proposed for your life in the mighty name of Jesus. No matter how difficult things may seem, I declare over your life that your tomorrow will be better than your today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. By the grace of God, we're in the month of October, our month of by their fruits. And I'm praying that you will produce good fruits, fruits that will last and will stand the test of time, enduring fruits that will cause your joy to be complete in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, our prayer is going to focus around ensuring that we have good reports. Amen? Because when we talk about producing fruits, we are also talking about our reports. The actions that we take, they are evaluated. People can know the kind of persons that we are on account of the fruits that we produce out of the actions that we take. Praise the name of the Lord. Matthew chapter 12, verses 33 to 37. Matthew 12, 33 to 37 is going to form our anchor scripture for our prayers this morning. So quickly, I'll read it and we'll go straight into prayers. Matthew 12, 33 to 37. He says, either make the tree good and its fruit good, or else make the tree bad and its fruit bad. For a tree is known by its fruits. Brood of vipers, how can you, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good things. And an evil man out of the evil treasure brings forth evil things. But I say to you that for every idle word men may speak, they will give account of it in the day of judgment. For by their words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned. Praise the mighty name of the Lord. This is Jesus Christ speaking here. Beloved, we are meant to produce good fruits. And this is born out of the good treasure of the heart. Fruits you produce are the evidence of what you are made of. Amen. Jesus said in Matthew 16, 13 to 19, Matthew 16, 13 to 19, that only a good tree can produce good fruits, and vice versa, a bad tree will produce bad fruit. Remember that was said that the tree represents us as individuals. And the actions that we take and what we, the evidence of what our behavior, our actions are, the fruits that people can use to determine what kind of persons we are. It went further, Jesus, to say that by their fruits, you will know them. Amen. By their fruits, you will know them. In other words, by their actions, you can tell who is good or who is bad. As Christians, we must ensure that we have a good report so that by our actions, we can advance the kingdom of God and bring others out of darkness into the light of God's kingdom. As we pray this morning concerning our week, we shall be asking for grace and strength to produce good fruits through our actions, such that we shall have good reports in all our dealings in the mighty name of Jesus. This morning, I invite you to join us in prayers. And as you pray, I want you to believe with all your heart that God will answer for you. It will make every wrong in your life to become right. It will turn all errors into good things. It will turn all failures into success. It will turn all lack into abundance. And it will turn every sorrow into joy, so that your story will turn to glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This morning, I want us to start with a prayer of thanksgiving. Amen. According to Psalm 95, verse 1 and 2, O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. Let us shout joyfully with psalms. Let's go ahead and come into his presence with thanksgiving, thanking him for all that he has done for us. Thank him for how he has defended you, how he has provided for you, how he has secured you and your family, how he has kept you, how he continues to bless you, how he continues to fight your battles, how his mercies and his grace are evident in our lives. His compassion, they fail not. Let's come into his presence with a heart of thanksgiving, appreciating this God that protects us, provides for us, makes a way for us, defends us, does great things for us. Father, we your children, from our various locations this morning, we are saying thank you, Father. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for what you have done. Thank you for what you are going to do today. Thank you for what you're going to do even in this new week in our lives, our families, our business, our careers, all that concerns us, concerning our health, everything. Father, we are grateful and we come to you with a heart of joy, with a heart of thanksgiving, and we say, let your name alone be glorified in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. We ask, O Father, that you accept our thanks. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Amen, amen, and amen. Beloved, the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. And it's the fruit you produce that is an evidence of what you are made of. I want you to pray with your own mouth. A few prayers you will pray, then I will pray for you. I want you to pray and say, Father, please purge my heart from all forms of evil and wickedness, that I may produce good fruits in the name of Jesus. That's your first prayer or your second prayer this morning. I want you to pray and say, Father, purge my heart from all forms of evil and wickedness, that I may produce good fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I ask that you purge our hearts from all forms of evil and wickedness, because we know that the heart of man is desperately wicked. We ask, O God, that today, by your power, by your spiritual power, Father, let there be a purging of evil and wickedness out of our hearts, so that we can begin to produce good fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Still praying for yourself, you pray and say, Father, every tree of evil that has been standing in my life, producing evil fruits of failure, shame, and sorrow, destroying my destiny, by your mighty power, uproot completely in the mighty name of Jesus. You say, Father, every tree of evil that has been standing in my life, producing evil fruits of failure, of shame, and sorrow, destroying my destiny, say, by your mighty power, uproot completely in the mighty name of Jesus. Make that your prayer. Father, I pray every evil tree that has been standing trees of failure, of shame, of sorrow that have been destroying my destiny by your mighty power, uproot it completely in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Maybe one or two prayers you pray, then I will pray for you this morning. Jesus referred to the gathering of the evil people as brood of vipers, a gathering of evil, influencing evil and producing bad fruits, a gathering and association of wicked people that influence each other, and every one of them, they are producing bad fruits. So you're going to pray and say, Father, every association of vipers that have held sway in my life, by the power in the blood of Jesus, separate me from all of such right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to make that prayer very, very, very well. Because you see, sometimes the association we find ourselves, the friends, the colleagues, the associates, the people we move around with, they are the ones that are even pulling us down by their influence. Out of a gathering or a brood of vipers, there's evil being produced from top to bottom. So pray and say, Father, every association of vipers that has held sway in my life by your power, the power in the blood of Jesus, separate me from all such in the name of Jesus. Where my eyes needs to be open to see, please open my eyes and give me strength to flee all such evil association in the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall it be for you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Today I pray for you, beginning from right now, God shall give you a new heart of peace and joy, filled with the Holy Ghost, so that you shall begin to produce good and lasting fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you that from now on, your actions shall produce good reports, such that men will see you and give glory to God in heaven in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. According to Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 and 23, the Holy Spirit shall fill your hearts and you begin to produce all the fruits of the Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that you lay your hands to do all throughout this new week and even beyond, it shall begin to prosper, producing lasting and enduring fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you, dearly beloved. God shall give you grace in double portion to be able to make the right decisions in line with His will and purpose for your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Every time you are faced with decisions to make, God will open your eyes, give you the strength, give you the ability, insight, revelation, power, grace to take the decisions that are correct in line with His will for your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare over your life and your destiny, errors of the past shall not destroy your present or your future opportunities in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The grace and favor of God shall qualify you into greater glory, even this week and beyond, in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, I plead the blood of Jesus over you and your family and declare that the blood shall speak for you, the blood will conquer for you, and the blood will cause your joy to be full in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, I release the blessings of God upon you in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And I declare that as you step out today, your week is blessed. You will step out into greatness. You will have good reports. You begin to produce good fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything you set out to do shall be in line with the will of God for your life in the name of Jesus. God will give you strength. It will give you power. It will give you revelation. It will protect you. It will defend you, such that you will move from glory to glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Every error of yesterday, it will not terminate your good opportunities of today and tomorrow in the mighty name of Jesus. The Spirit of God will be round about you to protect you, to help you, to conquer for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Your life will give praise and glory to God. I declare over your life that you become a God pleaser rather than a man pleaser in the mighty name of Jesus. And as you step out today, you step into greatness, you step into help, you step into prosperity, you step into good reports, and you begin to produce good fruit. And I declare that you will never be stranded in life in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. As you go today, have the confidence in your heart, in your mind, that God is on your side and you will win and you'll become victorious in every area of your life in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The Lord bless you. Have a fruitful Sunday. Have a blessed week. Have a fruitful week in the mighty name of Jesus. Shalom.